Now, to talk a little bit more, or to give you an overview of the Tech Foundry initiatives that Dato was just talking about, if you could please put your hands together for Engineer Wan Mordani, Wan Muhammad, Director for Digital Enablement here at MDEC. Please give him a round of applause, please.
Assalamualaikum, everybody, good morning to all of you. Once again, on behalf of MDEC, like, thanks for all of you for being here today. I see familiar faces, and I also see unfamiliar faces. So that's good, because that shows the level of interest that you have on our initiative. Let me just go through some of the slides to set the expectation of where we are, where how do we came about this thing, and what takes us to this journey. If you can, some of you may recall, about 5 years ago, we started early intervention in developing the skills of our mobile developers. So it was pretty much M then. So we realized that the advent of the mobile devices have hit the critical mass about 5-6 years ago, and there were a lot of thousands and hundred thousands of applications that were put on the global platforms, which are mostly developed by the non-Malaysian developers. So then we realized that we have to put some initiative to start to impart some of the knowledge to our local developers to be able to develop mobile applications based on the global platforms, be it iOS, Android, Windows, and of course BlackBerry back then. So I believe as of now we have matured in this thing, and then we have touched about 2,000 people in our early days in providing the mobile capability development program to the targeted participants, and we have produced about 200 applications, and we have a fair achievement as far as getting our locally flavored applications on the global platforms. And some of the companies who have made it, they have made it in terms of acquiring certain sales and acquiring the partners for them to grow. And fast forward to 5 years later now, and realize that in order for them to be sustainable in this very competitive environment, they need more than M. So this is where the SMAC thing comes in, the social media, of course, mobility, analytics, and cloud. So this, we realize that we need to impart this kind of best practices into our local developers. So having said that, as said by Dr. Wan Pei just now, we must expand the capabilities of our developers to be able to develop such products and services that will take into account of other technology fronts. They are quite mature in the mobility capability, so it's a matter of exposing them and ask them to be involved in the social media, to be involved in the analytics as well as cloud. Because you need all these four elements for them to build up a powerful and reachable product and services to the right market. Before this, when we did the social media thing, when we did the mobility training, so the aspects of programming and graphics were then very much prominent back then. But the thing is, how do they learn to capitalize on the unstructured data in the social media, be it on the existing global platforms such as Facebook, WhatsApp, and so on and so forth, or they can create their own web-based social platform for them to solicit the unstructured data from the customers. And from there, and we realize that the analytics has to play a role in analyzing those data and to become a meaningful services and product. And on top of that, to complete the ecosystem, this is where the cloud comes in. You need that cloud for you to be able to reduce the cost for you to deliver the product and services to the right market. Because clouds will enable you to leverage on the existing platform at a much lower cost than if you were to expand or you were to invest in the capital expenditures to buy the servers and things like that. So having said that, that's why I think moving forward, we have to ensure these four elements are really put into the place, really put into the system of development that we are putting in MDEC. So this is a set expectation of how MDEC came in about this program. It was not crafted on its own, but we started with early intervention, pushing the mobility and putting the smart capability as we go forward. And why fintech? Actually, MDEC is not an expert of fintech. I mean, all of you in this room are much more expert than us, so I leave it to the speakers out there to excite, inspire all the developers to be able to appreciate what fintech can offer as far as developing the solutions. But we know that as MDEC, coming from the perspective of agency that drive the digital economy, we know fintech is the future. We recognize that it has the high growth in terms of investments. If you recall, if you notice that last year alone in Asia Pacific, about close to 4 billion of investments were in fintech in more than 100 deals. It's about triple the value than it was in 2014. So that shows us that we have a good future in the fintech. And then in terms of banks being efficient, I believe some of the banks have taken steps to being efficient, by introducing some of the fintech technologies in their operation. So all those elements have actually prompted us to focus on the fintech instead of pushing our developers in the smart capabilities without any specific threats or specific focus. Then why not we use this leverage, this platform, to focus on the fintech so that we'll be able to meet the requirements and expectations of the industry. Okay, why do we do this thing? We have a four strategic pillars in MDEC. And fintech is just like any other techs, whether health tech, edutech, all those technology pillars are very important in driving the digital adoption. And fintech is certainly one of the focus areas that we want to move forward as far as building the right ecosystem, building the developer skills in this area. The first part is driving investments. We need investments to increase the supply of the resources as far as producing the solutions are concerned. And obviously, on top of mine is building the local tech champions. We believe that we have the right ingredients to start developing the global icons from the fintech arena. And this is the first step of placing that kind of opportunities into the actions. And the third one is about digital ecosystem. In MDEC, the focus areas has always been on the e-commerce, cloud, IoT, BDA, and security. And those elements of ecosystem are very important and crucial in delivering the right fintech solutions. So it's about connecting the dots of what we already have developed earlier. It's not fintech in MDEC is not being created out of nowhere. We have built a right capability and supply in those focus areas, so it's a matter of how do we leverage on those focus areas, and together we can build a fintech solution that are of relevance to the market that we are targeting. And lastly, inclusivity. This is the fourth pillar of MDEC. We believe that fintech will be able to roll out the services to the new market. People who have no access to the financial services under the normal conventional banking services, for example, unbanked population. So this could be the new market that we want to bring in. So whatever solution that have been built are meant to serve the underserved markets that I believe we have a pocket of those underserved markets in Malaysia, as well as it provides the opportunities for our players to export our solutions to the regional market that require such financial services in the technology. So those are the mapping of fintech into MDEC four pillars of ecosystem. So in essence, what we are doing now is very much in line with the MDEC direction moving forward in driving the digital adoption. Okay, this is my last slide. So then the conference title is MDEC Fintech Conference. This is not about the fintech. The fintech is brought in for us to be able to scale up our developers. We need a focus area, which is fintech. But what is more important moving forward is how do we develop our developers? We have a program or initiative, what we call the Developer Tech Foundry. This is like a factory of producing the developers, but we have to admit that we cannot produce the scale. So that's why it has three levels of intervention. The first one is the mobility capability that we are building. It is an evolution of what we have done 5 years ago. We have touched about 2,000 people, but we do not have the resources to touch everybody in Malaysia. So that is why our next approach of building that capability in the mobility section is by working out the initiative with Ministry of Higher Education with the intention of imparting that into the curriculum of the TVET. So with that, then they have the skills of rolling out the training to all the polytech students all over Malaysia. So this is our scale-up strategy that we are putting in, because we are no longer going to do a direct intervention with the pocket of developers. We have done that for the 5 years. It's now timely for us to move and scale up that kind of developers through different means, which is through the adoption of that components into the TVET curriculum. Let's move on to level two. This is where we are today. The level two is about bringing in the developers who have reached the maturity for them to be able to participate in this program. This is where the fintech developer bootcamp comes into the picture. So we are going to select a number of qualified developers to undergo a three-month program where we're going to have a bootcamp, we're going to have a design workshop, which Bikesh will be explaining later on the concepts and methodology of that thing. But the intention is to get our mature developers, be it from private developers or even the banks themselves can send their stuff. Or we are open to any kind of developers to be part of this initiative. And obviously, MDEC status companies are one of the funders that we are putting in. So they will undergo this kind of structured developmental program with our partners, iTrain. And the other day is how do they pitch their product in the demo day. So this is where I think I really encourage the private sectors, the banks, the VCs to support us in this thing because you know the best. Because they are building the solutions toward the needs of the market. And once they have pitched in the demo day, that is where the third levels come in. This is the co-creation. What we want to do is we want to pilot the co-creation of solution that meet the industry standards through the collaboration with the banks or with any other financial services sector that would want to develop that kind of solution. So I urge all the banks to make use of this platform instead of reinventing the wheel, then we are open to this kind of collaboration with all the partners that we have, be it banks or private partners, to participate in this initiative. And the day is to bring this level 2 developers to level 3 where they can create a solution. Then we leave it to the market forces, the commercial agreement between the banks, between the private partners, with our developers, whether it will be a licensing right, co-investment, or outright purchase. That would be something, the model that has to be discussed further. But what is more important is I want to highlight that this is the platform that we are going to push for the next 3 months, and fintech is a focus area that we are pushing in. So this is not crafted out of stone. This is something that we want to build our ecosystem by touching the right mix of developers who want to be part of this exciting journey. I think that's about it. I think we're going to have a next session to discuss and to brief on the details of the Tech Foundry program. How do you participate in that thing? And I hope that this will create excitement and inspire all the developers or any other stakeholders who want to be participate in this thing. So without further ado, we'll see you later. Thank you very much for your attention. Thanks.